Hello everyone, this is Rajiv and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial we will create cannon fire animation using masking techniques, and this animation is inspired by the work of Ivan Kovalenko at dribble.com. and the most important thing to learn in this tutorial is how we are hiding this cannon ball inside this cannon barrel. So in this colored view you don't see the cannon ball coming from diagonally down, but in the outline view you can see that it is coming right from here, this point, and then move inside the cannon barrel. But in the colored view you don't see this. So that is what you are going to learn in this tutorial. So let's get started. And here we have total 8 slides, 4 slides with the colored view and 4 slides with only the outline view. And you can easily see the outline view of any presentation that you download. And you can also download this presentation from the link in the video description. You can select all the objects in the slide by pressing the Ctrl A key, or you can go to the select drop down button from the home tab and then choose select all. And then go to the shape format and choose no fill and shape outline, set it to any color. So that way you can see only the outline view of any object on the slide. So let me undo this. And even in the outline view you can still see that this cannon barrel is still having the blue color. So after applying the no fill, it is not removing this blue color. That is because this shape has been later converted to a picture. So I will show you that how I did this and why I did so. So let's move back to the first slide. And here you should also open the selection pane when you open someone else's presentation, so you can see all the shapes and objects used in that particular. So in this first slide you can see that we have two grouped objects, cannon barrel and cannon carriage. So if I hide one of them, then you can see the rest. You can hide and unhide any object using this I button. So you can see that which name corresponds to which object on the slide. If I go to the animations tab and go to the animation pan, then you can see that we only applied a single animation on this first slide, and that is the spin animation effect. And if you double click on this effect, then you can also see the effect option properties. And we are moving this object 8 degrees clockwise without any smoothness and auto reverse, and the timing is 1 second. And we are also playing this animation with previous. So I want when I see the slideshow, then it should start the animation effect immediately and there is no delay. So hit the OK key. And if you want to see the slideshow of a single slide in a loop, then what you can do, you can hide rest of the slides. Like I can select this second slide here and hold down the shift key and then select the last slide, right click and then choose hide slide. Now from the slideshow tab, go to setup slideshow and make a check mark on loop continuously until escape. So now if you will see the slideshow, then only the first slide will appear in the slideshow and will continue to run in a loop. So here you can see that the cannon barrel is moving at 8 degree clockwise, and we converted this cannon barrel into a picture. And when you select this shape or picture here, then you can see that we now have two additional tabs on top, shape format and picture format. However, when you select only the cannon carriage, then you only see the shape format tab. So that is because this shape has been later converted into a picture. And you can easily do that by going to insert shape. Let's say I draw a shape here and another shape on top, like a triangle, and then I change the fill color of this triangle. Now I want to convert both of these shapes as a picture. So first I will group them. Now I will go to the home tab, will click on the copy button, and instead of clicking the paste, I will click on this drop down button and will choose paste as picture. You can also access this by right clicking and then choose paste as picture. So now you can see that we have this picture format tab on top because the same shapes are now converted into a picture. So now if I select this cannon barrel, the important thing to note here is that where the anchor point of this cannon barrel is. So when I select this picture, you can see the selection here. the selection is larger than the picture size. So if I, let's say, insert another shape here and if I rotate it, then you can see that how it is rotating from the center point. The anchor point is right here now, the default anchor point. But if you want to define your own anchor point, then you can insert another shape, let's say an oval here, and reduce the size. And I want the anchor point right here, so when I rotate this triangle, then it should rotate from this point, not from center. So I will select both of these shapes and will create a group. And now if I will move this oval only, then it will change the anchor point. Now you can see the anchor point. This one is right here at this point. I will move a little bit more to the left, like this. And the horizontal anchor point is right here at this point. I want it right here, so I will move it up. So these dots will start moving up also. Now, okay, that is fine, and I will hide this oval. So during the slideshow, we don't want to see this oval here. So I will choose no fill and no outline. And now we have the anchor point at the corner, left corner, and it will rotate like this. So on the first slide, this cannon barrel is only moving at 80 degrees. That is all. So now let's move to the second slide and right click and choose unhide. And on the second slide, you can see the cannon bar is having the diagonal motion path animation effect. So you can see it is coming from right from this position inside the cannon bar. So here in the selection pane, you now can see that we have more than two objects. We have total four objects on this slide, and one is cannon barrel with top part, and another is cannon barrel bottom part. And then we have the mask and cannon bar in between both of these shapes. So you must also note down the position of each of the object on the slide, and that is very important. And let me show you the mask shape here, and it is not visible on the slide because the shape and the background of the slide are having the same white color. So let's say if I change the color of this mask or the slide, let's say we change the color of this background, format background, and then choose solid fill. Let's say we apply any color here, and now you can see that mask here. So why we created this shape, and we created this shape using the freeform shape tool, and I have already taught many times that how you should use this freeform shape. Like click here and then don't continuously click the left mouse button. Instead, start clicking once and then move your mouse pointer. And then another click to add another point, then another point with left click, then another point, and that way you can create your own custom shapes. And later we also have the option under edit shape, edit points, and that way you can give curves to your points. You can add more points or delete point by right clicking on a point, like delete point, and if you want to add a new point, just select from the position and then just move the mouse and it will add a new point to the shape. So that way I have created this mask here to hide the cannon bar behind it. So on the second slide, you can see that we have grouped cannon carriage with the cannon barrel, but the cannon barrel is in two parts here. So that is why we had converted this cannon barrel into a picture, because we later crop this picture into two parts. One is the cannon barrel top and one is cannon barrel bottom. So why I did so, I will show you next. So let me undo all this. So if we again see the selection pane and hide all of the objects and then just turn on this one, cannon and barrel top part. So that shape is on top of all the other parts, and then we have this mask, the white mask that is you are not seeing right now. But if I move this white mask here, then you will start seeing the cannon bar in the background. So we have placed this cannon bar right here and we want to move it right inside the cannon barrel. So when it will move like this, So without the mask you will see that during the slideshow, and we don't want this, so that is why we created this mask shape and placed on top of the cannonball. So that is why we first have the cannon carriage with barrel top, and then we have the mask, and then we are hiding the cannonball behind that mask, and then we have the barrel back part, that one, and that part is behind all the other parts. So when the cannonball will move, it will remain hidden behind the mask, and when it will come to this point, then it will look like that it is coming inside from the cannon barrel. That is why we have converted this cannon barrel into a picture and divided it into two parts, so we can place the cannon ball on the third position between the top and the bottom part of the barrel. So now let's unhide this third slide, and here we again have two objects. And if we open the animation pan, so here on the third slide we have only used one animation effect, and that is the spin animation effect, and we are again moving that to 8 degree counterclockwise without any smoothness and auto reverse. The duration is short, half a second, without any delay. Again, I would like to tell you that you always should see the selection pan to note down how the objects are appearing on the slide. Like now, if I unhide this cannon carriage, then you can see that we have grouped the cannon barrel and cannon ball together. And that is because we want both of these objects to move counterclockwise at 8 degrees, like this. So that is why we group both of these objects together on the third slide. Now let me undo this and show this object. Now let's unhide the fourth slide. Now on the fourth slide you can now see that we again grouped and ungrouped the objects and converted them into six different parts. So I will show each of the part one by one, so you may guess that how the item has been placed on the fourth slide. So let's see. First we have barrel 2, and then we have this cannon, and then we have barrel top. But when I will turn on this barrel top, you are not seeing that on this slide. So if I hide this one, barrel 2, then you will start seeing the half part of the barrel. And then we have the cannonball, then the barrel bottom. Let me hide this cannonball so you can also see the cannon barrel bottom. So we also have the barrel in two parts, top and bottom, and we also have a barrel in a single shape. And then we again have the cannon, and then the cannon carriage. So why there are duplicate objects like cannon carriages two times, then we have barrel in a single shape and then barrel in two parts, top and bottom. So why we are using duplicate objects on this slide? For that you need to see the animation pan, and here you can see that we have used a few animation effects. Like first the ball will move out of the slide. So the first animation effect is diagonal upright, which has been applied on this cannonball, and that will move that cannonball outside the slide like this. So it will create a fire animation. And if you go to the animations tab, you can see the duration is very short, 0.25, but we also have a delay here, 0.25 seconds. And then we want the cannon carriage, barrel bottom and barrel top to get disappear. And for that, we have applied the disappear animation effect with previous, with a delay of 0.25 seconds on these three objects. And then we want the barrel 2 and the cannon, the duplicate objects, to get appear. So as I had shown you in the third slide, that what is the difference between the barrel bottom top and a grouped barrel. So then we want the grouped, the top and bottom part grouped together to appear at a specific point on the fourth slide, and also the duplicate cannon. We are hiding this cannon carriage, like let me show you, hide all of these and show you the cannon carriage. And what is the difference between both of them? You can see here we also have an anchor point on this cannon. When the fire when the cannonball will get fired, then it should show like this, from this point here. So that is why we have defined an custom anchor point to this cannon, and but you don't see that on this cannon carriage. So after both of these objects get appear on the slide, then we applied the spin animation effect 4 times, 3 times on the barrel and 1 time on the cannon, but repeating it 2 times. So if you open the effect option properties, then you can see that we are spinning these objects at certain degree, like 4 degree counterclockwise, 3 degree counterclockwise, again 3 degree counterclockwise, and then 2 degree counterclockwise, and these animation effects have different delay timings. So if I hide rest of the slides and show you only the 4 slides, then you can see that how the cannonball is moving out of the slide, and then it creates a shocking effect. And now let me hide all of these and show you only the outline view, so you may have a better understanding that how this animation effect is behaving. And then finally, we also applied the advanced slide timings according to the duration of animation effects. Like this effect is ending at 1 second, and we also applied the same transition timing 1 second under the advanced slide section. So I want this animation to play and then immediately move to the second slide without any delay. Then again on the second slide, we have a advanced slide timing of 1 second, and the effect timing is also 1 second. And then after that, it will immediately move to the third slide. And on the third slide, the animation effect ends at 0.5 second. And we are using the transition timing of 1 second. So that will create 0.5 second delay between third and fourth slide. So after the animation ends on the third slide, it will stay there for 0.5 more second, and then it will move to the fourth slide. And here on the fourth slide, the last animation ends at 1.05 second, but the transition timing is 2 seconds. So it will stay on the fourth slide for about 1 second more. And if you are looping this slideshow using this option, then after another 1 second delay, it will move back to the first slide. So let me unhide all of these slides and show you the slideshow once again. So I hope you might have an idea that how I had created this cannon animation using the masking technique. And if you like this tutorial, let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel and turn on the notification for more upcoming videos in the future. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and have a great day.